What's up guys, it's Solid007 and today I'm gonna show you and help you with the best settings for MGO2 PC and even some in-game settings I've been using all these years or these days. So let's get started. First, see below down description my PC specs. So they are decent specs, so and the settings, custom configuration, this depends on how well your PC performs, so I try to help with the best settings for you guys. As you can see, I go in right down here with the NVIDIA panel. Make sure you have the best possible frames per second setup on the PC controlling panel with your graphics card, and I also use more color. It looks better with the more color when playing the games, even MGO. And make sure on the controller panel settings you have this panel tab right here put to the best possible performance instead of quality. So that's one of that can help your PCs perform better. I'm not gonna change them, I already changed them. And one thing I use and use all as well, go to the PC, your PC power settings, and make sure the power plan is set to best performance, not balanced, which it even recommends for me. But make sure the PC's power plan is set to best performance. I'm sorry for the language, but I guess you understand this quite a bit, even if it's in my language in Finnish. One thing I also changed. And one thing you can put from the settings of your PC, go to the gaming. And one thing I use and did from the gaming settings of your PC. And here I have RBC S3 put as best performance for the graphics card. So that's what one thing you should do as well. And then you can change here the look your PC performs and as well. But put it as the best performance as well here. From advanced settings optimized to best performance for softwares. That's the main things with the PC settings of mine right now. And for the controller of the PS3 I use, it's the official all OG Sony 3, DualShock 3. I use DSHMC, as you can see, I need to run it as administrator to make it work properly. So yes, run it as admin, and I can even use this with Bluetooth and not with wire, because if I use wired controller with this, it kinda keeps disconnecting a lot. So just keep holding after you've done the settings for this, which you can probably find yourself if you're interested in doing this. Hit mini control, hold down the BS button, and there comes the Bluetooth connected, and outbreak rate control is right here, 1 millisecond, so it reacts faster the buttons you press, which can be advanced as well for you guys. There's the settings for my controller. Now let's get onto the emulator. As most of you know, we got an update earlier yesterday. So some PCs, most PCs got better FPS now as well as mine. I get around 5 plus better FPS now. Here are the most useful configurations for MGO2 PC that I've been using ever since it got, and what the devs say on Discord and recommend to use. PBU decoder. Fastest SPU decoder, fastest enable SPU loop detection, SPU catch, fluid accuracy, put it on loose from the CPU tab, I mean, and SPU block size. This is if you wanna boost your performance when you play, put it to giga. Preferred SPU threads, you can play with these, but I think auto is the best, as the devs say also. Now let's move on the GPU tab. Render, you always need Vulkan. It's the best possible renderer. Here's my graphics device, NVIDIA GeForce RTX 3020. Aspect ratio, of course, 16 and 9. Frame limit, don't think you should play with this a lot, but 60 is the one you need and want. So some people put it auto or off so they can get better frames, or even at 50, but I don't think it's a really good idea. Keep it on 60. Anisotropic filter, it could be automatic, but if you put it more the higher, then the FPS can go down a lot, so you say the two are automatic. Anti-aliasing disabled, so quality might of the game is a little bit worse, but FPS is better. Default resolution is always recommended, but I want to resolution scale it to 1080p, but I think since devs say it doesn't matter even if it's 2K quality resolution in game, so I'm gonna try and play with that. That's the only thing I'm gonna change now after the update, since apparently it doesn't put your performance of the PC down much, but the resolution on MGO PC looks so much smoother with this resolution, so I wanna play on it, at least that's for now. I have a little bit audio issues with my PC while playing the game still, so that's why it's either recommended audio out is X Audio 2. I don't know if I should test open now, but it's been fine with this. And in-app buffering, audio buffer duration 100 milliseconds. Maybe a little bit better if you want it to make the performance more better, but a little bit delaying. Then also in-app time stretching to avoid audio stuttering or lagging. Let's move on to the system. These are not very important. If you want it, the game to be on Japanese, it's gonna be English UK, then it's gonna be console language, gonna be, and the in-game stuff all gonna be in Japanese, even the voices, I think, which is kind of fun even play with those, but console language English US. Now the new settings we got with this update. Graphics, disable HUD. If you enable click this, the whole screen gonna be black and you'll see nothing. So keep this unchecked. Now we have these kind of settings. Disable motion blur. Disable the slight blur effect when objects are moving on screen. Click that. Reduce stage quality. Remove some transparency effects on stage for a moderate performance shoot boost. Check that as well. Here, keep this unchecked. Sleep timers accurate. Use sleeps only. Maximum number of burst rates. I don't know if I should change this, but I'm gonna keep it still on limited default. Always load level 2 SPRX only. This closely emulates how games can load and unload system model files on a real PlayStation 3. Some games require this. This is the preferred option, so use the preferred option. Relaxed school sync. This is important setting, you should click and use it. Use with caution and if performance or stability is compromised, keep this disabled. But I think it can improve performance in some games, but can also cause stability issues. But they devs say, and even I use this, so keep it on and enable it at least. Driver wake up delay, the more it's higher, the worse performance gets, but if it gets too low, then you're gonna get a lot of crashes, which I also noticed and heard. So don't use this more, don't put it more down than 200. But don't also put it up too much, because it's gonna decrease the performance. V-blank frequency, put it to maximum. Clock scale 100%. Okay, next step, emulator. Exit, this doesn't matter. Automatically start games, the boost checked. Start games in full screen mode, as full screen mode is recommended, check. you want to see frame rate in the window display, if you play with borders in full screen, you can check it. If you want to type in like on PS3 on OG or Revival or save MGO with the normal, the original one, how you can write in the game, use native user interface and check that. But I'm not going to use, I'm going to use the new one for the PC for writing in the game. Max compile rates all 16, obviously. Use as many as possible you can. Debug. Disable Google occlusion queries. Minor to moderate performance boost. So that should be checked. Use GBI texture scaling, which can also help with performance. So it's gonna be checked for me. Right, there's pretty much the most important settings I'm using, at least for this my PC. So I'm gonna go with this. Always remember to boot with custom configuration when you start MGO. My controller got disconnected. I'm reconnecting it again. PS3 button and voila. Output rate control 1 milliseconds with the best possible recognition. Refresh. Now you can see it's working. But only bad thing with this PS3 original Sony's DualShock 3 controller is that there's vibration, even if they are unchecked in Apple vibration, so it kind of bothers a bit, but it's fine. You can do right now anything about it, I think. But yeah, boot with custom configuration. Top right, you can see my FPS from the NVIDIA controller panel settings. I put it on right here if you want to use it. 1 second, it's downloading. If you want to see the FPS without emulators, you can go to the NVIDIA control panel with Alt and G right here. HUD performance FPS down there, up there. There it is. Top right. If you want to see it like this, this is not good because it's not in full screen mode, so this is better, right?
Right.
Alright, here we are. On the main menus and lobbies, it's easily keeping the 60 frames maximum frame rate, but when the more players join and you get into the game and shooting and grenade explosion starts, it drops down. That's the problem. Even still for me with this PC after the update, but it's fine to play like this, better still than PS3. Here's are my settings I always use to play, most of the time anyway. Load on, network settings, Ubi and universal plug and play always on. Port, if you're having problems joining host games, it also can help you if you change this to 5732. Then after you've changed it, you can get into the game. That's the thing you need to change if you can't get into the game, because you might not just be blocked, it can be your port. Upload limit, 96k is back after the update, but I think I heard devs say that doesn't matter, it automatically gets at least the default to the 256. So I've been most of the times whenever playing since 2008 using default or 512. But I don't know, they're both pretty good. Find out the default, I guess. Now I'm gonna show some in-game stuff from the gameplay section. Here are my settings I've been using mostly on the Revival server. Back in original MGO, I used to, most of the time use all camera speed as 10s. But the VF change speed should be lower than them. At least I like it more because it's a game changer in my opinion. It's kind of more sharp and accurate and looks cooler to aim and shoot. I don't know, but Right now, these are my settings for camera speeds. Normal VF movement speed 6, for the shoulder and VF movement boot 8, first person camera VF speed 8, VF change speed 6. First person VF memory, you don't want to enable that. Radar orientation default on. I used to pack an OC, but HUD display size too small, but normal is fine. Large is too big, but I like normal. Name tag level display, rotor level 90, I will see them. I keep those on. Weapon settings enabled, of course, so you can outline when you need or if it's enabled. These doesn't matter on the revival server. And these kind of doesn't matter either. You can't really use the mics yet on the PC. You can also on PC change the custom button configurations from the emulator settings. Item switch, I use it always recall mode because you can put the box and box pop faster, not need to press it twice or three or whatever. Recall is the best item switch for me at least. Weapon switch, sometimes I use it recall. I like it faster to change weapon and for main weapon to grenades because GSR is not always needed, but it kind of makes me play dumber, so I prefer quickly mode so I can use handgun as well and AA. And it's needed in team modes like team sneaking to get all three slots A, B, C. Oh, and one thing. On PC with the higher frame rates, it kind of, you need kind of lower your sensitivity than you normally use it on PS3 because at least one sensitive. Because it's smoother and faster frames, so you kind of need to lower it. At least one sensitive on the PC. If you come straight from the PS3. And here are some skill settings. Runner level 2 and assault rifle level 2. They are my most used as well as mainly. Many of the players will be using these two skill slots. But for team sneaking, I might use runner level 2. And maybe handgun level 1 and blades level 1 for team sneaking. So I can kind of get some easier attacking clips when using the stealth. And DDM and rescuer, monomanipulator assault rifle 2. And if there's grabbing points on and enemy locators come in, then you need the sub stealth. So, but mainly I use for campy modes assault rifle level 2. Runner level 1 and Monomania 3. That's pretty much my settings. Right, now we're going to the in-game, and as you can see it's still 60 FPS, but now it's going down when I join the game. Especially after I write, it's going down much. Now it's around 50. Going down a bit. And disable shadows for much better performance, even though it looks worse, but it is better. With the more FPS, it's better than the quality, so do that. At least for me, if you want to play better. So yeah. For now, it's around 40 FPS for me with shadows disabled. And when players join the game and come in and start shooting and grenades exposing and stuff happening, it gets worse, but pretty much it's something like this. Maybe a little bit lower. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Hope you get back on the gear and see you on the battlefield. The best online game.